Hey guys, it's Metal Dragon 132 coming back. I'm gonna do the first. I'm gonna do the second set of videos for you, like the servants' quarters. What's it called? Castle Armory. Okay, the four. The second set of four maps for you guys with built squire build tutorials. Alright, I'll tell you what I did back there. Hold on, let me get the chest so I can do the mana glitch. Okay, so back here, this bouncer block gate, you need that there. This one, that'd be essential, but you don't really need it here. Why I have it here? Hold on. I think I put it in the wrong position. Okay, I'd lay the harpoon first, if I were you. Lay the harpoon so it's sticking over the edge, like that. But if you have a bouncer right here, enemies will walk into this bouncer. They'll either come this way, tour it, and then walk back. Or else they'll not be knocked down into here. And when they get knocked into here, this bouncer will deal with them. Sorry, hold on. There we go. So, when that bouncer hits these enemies into here, this spot, and you don't have like anything over here to knock out these enemies real quickly, it's gonna get really flooded for this one bouncer if they all get knocked down into here. How you can prevent that? Place a bowling ball. This overflowing happens to me a lot, but you place a bowling ball right there, which it will go down that alley or whatever you call this, like a little hallway or something, and it will continue to shoot. And if your towers have good DPS for insane plus, because, like I said, they all do insane plus builds on level 60s. But if you place that bowling ball, it'll start injuring them, and it won't overflow your bouncer right here, and it won't take as much damage. There's going to be enough room for one more harpoon, so you guys can lay that wherever you guys want. In this build, it's not really essential, but the reason why you have one harpoon up there is because, if you can tell right there, there's not that many enemies, but down there has 9 to 5. So you lay a bouncer right here as close as you can. Shoot. Okay. Well, then you lay a bowling ball. You don't lay a harpoon because harpoons cannot do knockback damage. For some reason, My bowling ball does one more damage than my harpoon. But yeah, so you place a bowling balls go down here. For some reason, bowling ball turns do knockback damage, so it'll knock the enemies back into place. Then you place bouncers right here, because enemies, if you lay something right here, enemies will not walk on over, well, they'll still walk here, but they won't go after your crystal. So you lay these bouncers there, and they'll get injured and knocked back and all that. You lay a harpoon right before. So you see how my, like that point? See that point right there where like shoots out? I don't know how to get a good angle, but put that point like lined up with the farthest spike out, so they'll hit the harpoons. Then you place a bowling ball turret right behind it to do knockback, just in case. Then you come over here. This spot right here is where you'll have to do a little bit of DPS, because you'll have mages and they're not good. And you lay a harpoon behind it for any access lineages that are like not going to the bouncer. And this is what I meant by the one harpoon. See? You can lay this harpoon wherever you want, but this is like the central build. If I was gonna lay a harpoon somewhere, to be honest with you guys, I'd lay it back here. Because if you lay it back here, if you guys didn't know, if your harpoons have a lot of range, they can shoot this area right here too. So they can shoot over here, and they can shoot down here, which is pretty good. So let me get to that little spot right over here. This spot. Okay, so I'm gonna look at the map so you guys can see the build. There's the build. It's not bad for like a level 60, but with only squires, it's pretty good. Okay, now let's go to Castle Armory. Castle Armory's build is a little tricky because you have so many spots where the enemies can come from. Yeah, I'm doing this on hard just to show you guys without running out of time. But if I were going to do this with time, and you weren't doing the mana glitch, I would start out with bouncers. Because bouncer is like the best. Oops. I can do the mana glitch right now. Now in like Misty Mire or Morago or Aquanos, and you do the mana glitch, I'd only pick up one chest. But don't do the chest that does not respond after the next couple waves. Because then that's not good. You can get better loot from those chests. Okay. So how you want to do this, you want to lay a bow. Most people lay up slice and dice, but I don't get a slice and dice. Slice and dice. So you lay those right there, this right there. Now, the reason why you lay this right here, because when the enemies walk into it, they'll get knocked back. They'll get knocked back here, down here, or down here. You lay these two back here, or you can lay slice and dice, it's up to you. But I like these better, because they do more damage if you have fast attack rate, like I do. I don't know what gives me that. Oh yeah, my helmet. I gotta get a new one. Gotta get a new set of gear. It's all level 78 gear. But, oh, I am 78. Oops. So, yeah, you lay these right here, because then the enemies will be walking in there, and they'll come from down there. Then you just mimic the same side. You only need one in the middle for the first wave, and then you can double them up. But I did a mana glitch, so. Okay, so back here, you place them right back here. You want to place them, back here, because, or you can place them. How big is this? Hold on, yeah. I might change my build right now. You place, sorry, you might place bouncers. I'm keeping the front though. Don't worry about the front. Okay, so how you want your harpoons back here? You don't want archers shooting them. So you lay your harpoons back, away from like outcrops. Oops. So you lay two harpoons there. You lay one harp. Okay, the reason why you lay one right here is because harpoons can do piercing shot, so like it can go right through all enemies, which is pretty overpowered, I think. I wish all traps did that. But yeah, only harpoons. And that's so it hits multiple enemies. I'm sorry if you hear my wacko family. Then you lay bowling. Wait, how many defense? 22? 22. Okay, so. 7. Yeah. Bowling ball. Bowling ball. And then I got one more for 8. Yeah, I should have left this back here. Well, I don't know. Sorry. How big, how wide are my traps? Would that work?
You have an issue.
I'm not sure. You guys said that work? I'm not sure. Wait, if I take 6, I'll have 2 more defense units. Hold on. Yeah, sorry. My build is like better than. Oh, I don't know. So I got 10 more. 3. 3 and 7. See, I don't know what to do! Okay, you guys can figure out what you want to do with the 10. I meant 8. Because I like to use bowling ball turns as much as I can. Because they help out a lot. They do knockback and as much damage, almost as much damage, as your harpoons. So you guys can figure out what you guys want to do with the 8. Oops. You can change up my build. You can do whatever you guys want. But I'm going to, what's it called? Oh, man. Not Servant's Quarters. Hall of Quart. I think it's called Hall of Quart. Yeah. Okay. So next is Hall of Quart. So, I would start out with harpoons if you don't know how to do mana glitch. No, I meant bouncers. Sorry. So, you lay a bouncer right there. You lay a bouncer down here. You lay a bouncer down here is because if you, like I said, if your towers are not that good. What am I doing? If your towers are not that good, then they'll get knocked down or knocked back. If they get knocked down, the harpoon down there will hit them. No, sorry guys. The bouncer will hit them, and then, that will, I forget what I was saying, I'm gonna say. Then it'll practically kill them. Hold on. Sorry. Okay. Right here, you lay a bouncer down here. Now this map, you will have to DPS center because archers. Yeah, archers are gonna be the problem. Archers will go into the center. Into there, where that chest is. Or that little creek, if you take out the chest, they will go in there and start shooting your crystal. Which, not good. So you lay a bowling ball turret on the right side, of the map. Okay, you lay closest to the walls. And then you do the same on this side, closest to the wall. You lay it closest to the wall is because when the first set of enemies walk out, the bowling balls will start going. Hold on. sorry. Bowling balls will start going, and they'll start, when these enemies walk out, they'll start getting hit instead of hitting these. And then the enemies are down here. They'll rock, they'll slide up against the wall. If they come out of this, I think they just walk out here and then in the center and all that. But the enemies from here walk out along the wall and towards bowling ball turret. You can use slice and dice, but there's kobolds on this map. I have problem with kobolds going under my slice and dice, so yeah. Then you like to place a harpoon to get any archers that are starting to walk around all over. Which, if your harpoons don't have range, I don't know what to do. I've always had DP tower characters with range, so I don't know what to tell you. So you lay a harpoon there. You lay a harpoon back here, facing the crystal, and you lay another harpoon on this wood, like identical. Okay, so what that would do? These harpoons, if anything is coming from right here, harpoons will shoot at it, because some stuff can get stuck in the center of this. If it gets like on the center, it won't move. It'll literally stay there until it despawns. So your harpoons will shoot at it. Then you get this harpoon is if any those two harpoons are like shooting stuff, and they won't kill the wyverns. This harpoon will shoot the wyverns out of the sky. Then you do the same thing with this side. You lay a harpoon there. You lay a harpoon at the corner of there on both sides. You lay it right at the corner. You lay it right at the corner, because if you lay it at the corner, then they could shoot any archers back there. And then you lay one more back here. So that's how you do that. So there's the build. It's a lot of harpoons, less bowling balls, but it's an OP build, in my opinion. Okay, so I have to hurry up with throne room, or I'm going to have to reposition my laptop, which is going to happen, because I have 7% on my laptop right now. Oops, sorry guys. So, position my laptop. Okay, now I just got to plug it in. I hope this reaches. It does. Okay. Hey. Okay, I'm back. Okay, so let's do throwing them. Now, this was the big question for me and Smooth. We were trying to come up for builds with our level 27s or 26s squires. Not going out so well. But Smooth says he's found a build, or he made a build, one or the other. And we're going to try that, but I'm going to do my main build. I love squires. The only problem is they're so slow, but they're tanks. Like, my squire with its 73 health into it has almost 4k health. It's awesome. I almost said OP, but it's not. My DPS squire, I think, has like 10,000 or close to that, which I'm leader. My team DQ squire is going to be my tank squire when we finish him. Okay. Then I don't know what I'm going to make my hunters. Hold on. How far is that? Right at the edge. Okay. So you want to lay these right here, because if you lay them too close to the edge, they won't hit anything. If you lay them too close to each other, they'll walk around, which I don't think only I can, because of the lip. If there was no lip, they could walk around, but for some reason they don't walk on lips, so it's kind of good. You lay that right, that one. Now I got a mana glitch on. There are probably going to be a lot of bouncers in this, and blockades, and harpoons, I meant. Harpoons are good. But you might have to DPS wyverns, because harpoons don't automatically shoot for them unless if you move the harpoons back a good while. But, oh, I only used 28, wow. I thought I was going to use more. So, yeah, I might as well just do bowling balls. I hope. Blind balls are OP. I'm usually doing it with harpoons. If I have to switch it with you guys on camera, I don't care. You guys can be patient, right? It's builds. Builds are awesome. Do you guys know that builds are like your best teammate on this? Nothing else. Just your builds. Okay, harpoon there. Yeah, if you do not have good DPS towers, harpoons, this build's not for you. Yet. Yeah, yet. Okay, reason why you want three harpoons right here is because you'll have stuff running into that bouncer where my giraffe is, right here, and they can either get knocked back, or I've seen them, for some dumb reason, they would just get knocked back in down here. So I always triple barricade that. Next, you want to place harpoons here. I don't know how you're going to max out the DU. Oh, I'm thinking, hold on. 4, 6. Yeah, you can tell I'm doing math in my head. Hold on. Can you place anything? Oh, crap. Hold on, harpoon. You're going to have to leave. Can you place anything on this guy's head? Can you place a bowling ball? I was going to say, if you could place a bowling ball up there, you could just have bowling ball drop, so over here. Okay. Sorry. I just find that kind of funny. How about you? Oh, that's not bad. Place it. If you place it right there, and you place a bowling ball right there. Yeah, I'm gonna max that. DU for you guys. I like doing that. It gives you extra XP. Smooth is just talking to me about that. A while ago, though. Okay. So, there's a good build. If you would say. I just came up with that. I know it will work. But just keep an eye out for cobalt. Because you got, like, at wave, like, 10. Not 10. At, like, wave 7, you got, like, 30 cobalt coming out the front. And on the sides, you probably got, like, 29. And then 29. It gets hectic. But there you guys go. Here are the builds. Well, these are the builds. In my opinion, are good with squires. If you guys got any videos of builds that you would want me to check out and see if they work, and you guys want me to use them instead of mine, which probably will happen with this map, I will be gladly to use them on my squire adventures with Smooth. But if you guys know build, just say it in the comments. Make a video or just invite me on Xbox and I'll check it out. Yeah. See you guys. Thanks for watching.